guys, it's Jade here and welcome to your introduction to electricity. This tutorial is mainly going to focus on electric charge because they are the building blocks of all of electricity, whether you're learning about lightning or light bulbs. They are electricity. So we're going to start by talking about some of the history about how electricity was discovered. Now I know what you're thinking, Snoozeville, right? But I'm really going to try and make it fun, and turns out there's some pretty wacky stuff in there anyway, and studies show that a story is good for your memory, so I'll try and keep it brief. Then we're going to talk about some of the really basic but fundamental ideas you're going to have to know about, like what electricity is, how electric charges behave, that kind of thing. Then we're going to end by talking about some of the more sciencey, technical stuff you're going to need for the classroom. So if you're ready to embark on a journey, come with me back to ancient Egypt. So before anyone knew anything about electricity, the ancient Egyptians found these weird, mystical fish swimming in the Nile, where every time you touched one, you got this shock. So the ancient Egyptians didn't know these were electric fish, they just thought they were magical. They called them the thunderers of the Nile and thought that they were the protectors of all other fish. They thought that they were so magical, in fact, that they were used as a cure for headache. So if a patient came in with a headache, they were often asked to touch one of these magical fish, and the shock was thought to cure the headache. So my original plan for this video was to make fun of this idea because it sounds pretty crazy, right? But then I thought, you know, the ancient Egyptians, they were pretty clued on, they built the pyramids. So I decided to Google, does electric shock cure headache? And it turns out that there's this recent treatment for curing headache where you run an electric shock across your brain. So yeah, that showed me, I mean, maybe they were onto something. I've linked the article below if you want to check it out. And hey, next time you have a headache, try touching an electric fish. I'm actually curious now. But anyway, back to the point. The first recording of electricity were these thunderers of the Nile that were thought to cure headache back in ancient Egypt. Skipping forward a couple of millennia to the Mediterranean, the ancient Greeks discovered that if you rub certain objects like amber with cat's fur, it starts to attract other lighter objects like feathers. And this is actually where the word electricity comes from, the Greek word electron, which means amber. So that was the second recording of electricity in history. People still didn't really know what it meant, but they did know about this weird, mysterious force that existed between objects. So it wasn't until around the 18th century that people discovered that that force between objects was actually because of the electric charge. The balance or imbalance of electric charge largely dictated how an object behaved with another object. So the first most important thing you need to know if you want to understand electricity is there are two types of charges, positive and negative. So before we go on, I just want to make clear that the words positive and negative don't actually mean anything. They were coined by the ex-US president Benjamin Franklin, and he was just trying to demonstrate that there are two types of charges and they do opposite things. So it could easily have been another pair of opposites like black and white, or cat and dog. He just decided on positive and negative, and it works. So that's the first most important thing. There are two types of charges, positive and negative. The second most important thing is how these charges interact with one another. Through experiment, it was found that like charges repel and opposite charges attract. I'll say that again. Like charges repel and opposite charges attract. So, two positive charges, repel. Two negative charges, repel. One positive charge and one negative charge, attract. You get the idea. So it turns out everything has a charge. You have a charge, I have a charge, your cat has a charge, your mum has a charge, everything has a charge. So you might be wondering, why isn't everything repelling or attracting everything else? Even though every object has individual charges on it, most of the time there's an equal amount of positive and negative charge, leaving the overall charge of the object neutral. So even though there are positive and negative charges on the object itself isn't positively or negatively charged. It's neutrally charged. Okay, so now that we know a little bit more about charge and how it behaves, let's try and figure out what was going on back in ancient Greece with the amber and the feather. So before there was any rubbing, all the objects, the amber, feather, and cat's fur, were all electrically neutral, just like any other normal object. So when the cat's fur was rubbed onto the amber, negative charge was transferred from the cat's fur to the amber, which left the amber with an overall negative charge because it was started out neutral and it just got negative charge transferred to it. So now the amber is negatively charged. So when a neutral object like the feather was brought near the amber, because the amber was negatively charged, it repelled some of the negative charges in the feather because like charges repel. So this left the feather positively charged. So now that we have one negatively charged object, the amber, and one positively charged object, the feather, they attract because opposite charges attract. And the only reason that the feather moved toward the amber was because it was lighter. Did you get that? So you guys have a pretty good idea about what charge is now. So I just want to go over a couple of the more technical things that your teacher or lecturer are going to want you to know. So I just really want to stress that charge is not an object. Charge is a property of an object, just like mass or color. You can't really be like, hey, check out my 8 kilograms, or I'm holding this red. It's like 8 kilograms of what? Red what? Charge is the same. It can't exist without an object. It's a property of an object. The second thing is that because we're usually trying to measure charge, it needs a unit, and the SI unit for charge is the coulomb. And that's it. So the take-home messages of this video are, if you're ever going to make fun of the ancient Egyptians, make sure you've really done your research. Electric charges are the building blocks of all of electricity. There are two types of charges, positive and negative. Like charges repel and opposite charges attract. Charge is a property of an object, not an object itself. The SI unit of charge is the coulomb. And if you ever have a headache, try touching an electric fish and let me know how it goes. Thanks. Bye.